touch gloves. Kora.
This is for the heavyweight championship of the world. Hideki Sekine against Brandon Vera. This fight brought to you by Chunlong Yulur, D88.com. One championship belt at stake. You can see that big height advantage that Vera has immediately.
Yeah, that long reach is going to be a very difficult obstacle for Hideki Sekine to try to get close to. But he is a judo black belt. He's a Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt. He's got a wealth of grappling experience, so he's got to try to get in there and get one of those legs and drag this fight to the ground.
So far, it's Sekine. Whoa. Just takes a battering leg to the head, but he continues to circle the perimeter of the cage as Vera stalks him.
Those legs come with such heat and power.
Now he goes downstairs, the outside of Sekine's right leg.
Brandon Vera just stalking forward, looking for these shots. Sekine was almost there, he got close. I don't think Sekine's thrown a strike yet, but he's absorbed a couple of leg kicks. He can't take too many of those, or it's gonna also limit his ability to shoot in and possibly grab that single leg.
Scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds, nobody here at cage side seriously thinks it's gonna go 25 minutes.
He told me he wants to punch his way into a clinch and utilize some of those judo takedowns to get this fight to the ground.
Right hand, knee to the head from Vera. Sekine grabs hold and tries to press Vera up against the cage.
That's what he needs to do. He needs to pressure Vera, stay close to him, eliminate that striking ability, and utilize the takedown.
Tries for the knee to the head again. Sekine's overhand right missed, and I think he's in a little bit of trouble. Dabs at his right eye. Goes for the single leg, misses it badly. Brandon Vera has an opportunity now, but he backs off. Not wanting to get down there. Right hand straight to Sekine's face, and I think his nose is in a bit of trouble, the Japanese fighter. And the crowd chanting Brandon Vera's name so loudly that I can barely hear myself speak.
Brandon Vera must know that he has a huge advantage on the feet, and he's just waiting to pick his strikes. He's not being too overly aggressive. He knows Sekine is dangerous, and he could clinch up tight and drag the fight to the ground. But Vera's very patient, waiting to pick his shots.
Yeah, he really is being very patient, Vera. He's not going to get too excited and jump into a nest of vipers.
Yeah, his nose definitely looks crooked. I think that shot
definitely didn't look like that when he got in the cage. And that's a huge kick to the head. And that nose will be no better off as a result, I can assure you.
Yeah, his nose is going the wrong way. Oh, a body shot, that hurt him.
And he goes upstairs as well. And it's gonna be a matter of time now. There's blood from the nose, the punches come down. Yuji Shimada steps in, and Brandon Vera has retained his one championship heavyweight title in front of his home fans at the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila. Embraces his coach in the center of the cage. Everybody in this arena is on their feet. And their new countryman has just done the business for them. There's his celebration. He goes over to Hideki Sekine, whose face is understandably buried in a towel because it took tremendous punishment. And that is the measure of the man. He can unleash torture. The knee to the head was just an obliterating move. Sekine grabbed for all his worth. Brandon Vera jumps on top, sends in repeated left hands, and really it was just a question of time before Yuji Shimada stepped in. Let's get the quick thoughts of Rich Franklin.
I'll tell you, I'm just surprised Sekine lasted that long. After looking at his nose, his nose went completely crooked. I would imagine he probably did about 2 minutes of that round without any oxygen at all.
a measure of the man and the strength of character from the Japanese man. He's not coming to the center of the cage, I think. Better for him to stay on his stool as he hears the official decision from Don Lau. And just listen to this crowd.
To present the belts, we have Junlong Yula, D88.com ambassador and martial arts superstar, Andy On. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 3 minutes and 11 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, and still won!